radius of curvature, a recent board exam problem. Hi, hello, welcome back to Gillesania Engineering Videos, your daily supply of solutions to engineering problems. If you like what you see, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we upload new videos. Alright, in this video, we will discuss a problem involving radius of curvature, and this is one of the most recent board exam questions, okay? And in one of my video tutorial, specifically stresses in beams, I have derived there the formula for the radius of curvature. So if you want to know more about it, about its formulas and the elements of the formulas, you can refer to that video. Please refer to that video. Alright, so here is our problem. A flat steel bar is 50 mm wide by 5 mm thick and 300 mm long. The radius of curvature of the beam is the radius of curvature of a beam subject to a bending moment is given by the formula. So, nagbigay siya ng formula for the radius of curvature. We will use E equals 200 GPa. First question, calculate the radius of curvature of the bar if the maximum flexural stress is 124 MPa. Well, if you know the formula, this is just direct substitution actually. Part 2, compute the bending moment in the bar if the maximum bending stress developed in the bar is 164 MPa. So another direct substitution problem. And part 3, medyo challenging, compute the maximum deflection of the bar if a couple of 0.25 kN is applied at the ends. Okay, this is the bar. So 300 mm long, 5 mm thick, and 50 mm wide. Well, the problem did not say how this was bent, how the moment is applied, but obviously it should be applied on the weak axis. No? So, nakahiga dapat yung bar. Kasi kung nakatayo yan, mahirapan tayo mag-bend dyan. No? So, ito yung ating position. So, once applied, in-applyan siya ng moment at the ends, it will look like this. No? So, tinan nyo. Magiging ganito siya. Ayan. Right? So, you know, pag ibinend natin siya about the weak axis, it will bend. So, this remains 300 mm, the moment applied at both ends. Okay, so with that, because the moment applied or the moment on the entire section is the same, then this will form an exact arc of a circle of radius R. Alright, so radius R, let's say the central angle is theta here. Okay, so we have here the formula. So with the moment given, given pala yung bending stress, okay, we have to find the radius of curvature. The formula for R in terms of the moment applied is given by EI over M. So please refer to one of my videos in its derivation, for its derivation. Your E is given, your I is the section property, and in this case, it will be 50, the centroidal moment of inertia of this portion here. So, BD cube over 12. And the bending moment, which is not known pa. What we are given is the bending stress. Okay? So, we know the bending stress. Then, we can compute the bending moment. So, okay, the maximum bending stress is MC over I. Or if we compute M from that, that will be M is equal to FBI over C. Okay? Now, if you will replace this M with that formula, okay, we will replace this M with that formula. This formula now becomes EI over M. And simplifying this formula, then the radius of curvature can be expressed in terms of the maximum bending stress. And it will be E times C over the maximum bending stress. Where C is the distance from the neutral axis to the outermost fiber. So we can use this formula in this part. And this is just direct substitution, if you know the formula already. Alright, so substitute, your E is 200,000, your C is half of 5 mm, oh, that's 2.5, divided by the maximum bending stress given as 124 MPa. So the radius of curvature is in mm, 4032 mm or 4.032 meters. Answer. So that will be letter A. Okay, very simple. Especially if you know the formula. It's just direct substitution now. Okay, part 2. Calculate the radius of curvature of Part 2, compute the bending moment in the bar if the maximum bending stress is given. Actually, we can use this one, then we can diretso na. Or since rectangular yan, we can also use the formula for rectangular bar or rectangular section. Alright? Or we can use this one na lang. So, given ang maximum bending stress, your M is the one being asked here. Your C is half of 5. Your I is BD cube over 12. Or, as what I've said a while ago, we can use this formula here. This is for rectangular beam. Your B is 50, your D is 5. So, let's just use na lang this formula. Your bending stress is given, B is 50, D is 5. Then, we can solve for the value of M. And the answer is 34,167 Newton mm or 34.167 kilonewton meter. Okay? Okay. Okay. By the way, correction, no? It should be Newton meter divided by 1,000. No? The unit must be not kilonewton meter as what I earlier posted. It should be Newton meter. So that will be letter D. Letter D. Okay? So, no problem. Now, the third part is compute the maximum deflection of the bar if a couple of 0.25 kilonewton meter is applied at the ends of the bar. So, your M is 0.25 kilonewton meter. So, how are we going to solve the deflection? Is there a formula for that? But, well, knowing geometry, knowing the radius, and knowing that this is an arc of a circle, and the length of that arc is 300, we can use or we can compute the deflection if you know what deflection is. Nah? What is the deflection? How do you define deflection? It is the deviation from the original position, the undeformed position. Of course, in this figure, the undeformed position is straight line. Okay? So, ayan. So, but before that, let's solve first the radius of curvature. So, with the known moment, with the known E and I, we can solve the radius of curvature. And that will be 416.67 millimeters. Okay? Now, this is now the shape or the assumed position or path or elastic curve, shall we say. No? Ito yung position ngayon ng ating beam. Yung red na yan. No? That red line there. Alright? So, the length of that is 300 mm. And knowing the radius and knowing that length, the length of arc, we can compute the angle here. Alright, from the formula, length of arc equals the product of arc times the central angle, then we can compute the angle theta. And theta is equal to 0.72 radian or that is 41.25 degrees. So how do we find the deflection? So the deflection, as what I've said before, it is the position relative to its original. No? Okay, so this is it. Ito yung original position ng beam before we apply the moment. And the deviation from that is the deflection. And of course, the maximum is at the center. That's it. This is the maximum deflection. So, we will solve that one. Okay? So, to solve that, we will just use geometry. We don't have to use a formula in dynamics or in strength of materials. Okay? So, to get that one, let's consider this triangle here. Okay? Of course, from here up to here is the radius. Then we know the R, we know the theta already. And of course, by symmetry, this is theta over 2. Then we can compute this height here, from here up to here. That will be R cosine of theta over 2. Correct. This one, from here up to here only, at this blue, the initial position. So that's 389.96. And from the center here to this point, we know that is the radius of the circle. Yes, that's R, which is already known, 416.67. So therefore, the deflection is equal to R minus R cosine theta over 2, or this one minus that one, and that will give you 26.71 millimeters. Okay? So that's it. Huh? Well, you can derive a formula for that. Okay? So no problem. By the way, I'd like to explain something here because some student asked me about this formula. Sabi nila, sir, can we apply this formula? Let's see. Okay, they remember this formula cantilever beam subject to bending moment, moment applied at the end, ML squared over 2EI. You might be familiar with that formula. Well, if you apply that formula, your M is known. The formula will give you 108 mm. Well, why not 26.71? Okay? Mabuti na lang, walang 108 dito sa choice. Kasi kung meron, baka piliin nyo yan. Actually, this value is correct, but the situation is like this. Tingnan nyo. Okay, that is for a cantilever beam subject to bending moment at the end. Naturally, if this is M, this is also M. But that deflection is from the original position which is tangent to one end. The position of the beam of the of this red line here, okay? Please observe my transition. All right? Ayan. Okay? Tangent to one end of this red elastic curve. This is your delta 1, 108. But what we are up to in this problem is not that one but this one here. This is the delta that we want to compute. Kaya malaki, no? This is just 26.71 and this is 108 mm. All right? So I hope that is very clear and you learned a lot from this very short tutorial video. So please hit the like, paki-like naman ng video namin and paki-share naman sa mga kaibigan ninyo, ha? So I hope you learned a lot. And please don't forget to subscribe sa channel namin and hit the bell icon so that you will be notified every time we upload new videos. So thank you so much for watching.